7 years ago, Notch sold Minecraft, but before he left, he added several secret things into the game. In this video, I'll go over 25 of them, and I guarantee you that you didn't know these existed. Every April Fools, Notch had something up his sleeve. In 2010, he announced Minecraft 4D. In 2011, he added a locked chest into the game. In 2012, Notch created a hoax website for a new game titled Mars Effect. In 2013, he added a banner for Minecraft 2.0, a pink wither, a talking block of coal, a redstone silverfish, and a new super hostile game mode. The following year, Notch left Mojang. Number 2. Before crafting tables were added, you could access the 3x3 grid just by pressing B. The first ever crafting recipe was turning an apple into an arrow. But then crafting tables were added and now pressing B does absolutely nothing. Actually, I lied. Mojang never added crafting tables. They added a block called workbench. Yeah, that's what crafting tables were called at first. But fortunately, in beta, Notch renamed the workbench to crafting table. Back in Minecraft Infdev, there used to be brick pyramids that would naturally generate. Their purpose? A way of obtaining bricks, as there was no other way to get them. Since the height limit at the time was only 64 and ground level was 32, the pyramid itself was just 32 blocks high. That's nothing compared to my pyramid. A full brick pyramid would contain over 43,000 brick blocks. They were even rarer than the current rarest structure. Mansions, however, aren't solid. They contain dozens of different rooms, 53 types to be exact, which means all mansions are missing some of them. But the most interesting rooms are the secret rooms, such as X room, spider room, fake end portal room, obsidian room, birch pillar room, clean chest room, lava room, and attic room, with the X room being the most common and the lava room being the rarest. Number 5. In Java Edition, the patterns of bedrock are consistent in all worlds regardless of the seed. So at 0.0 you'll find this bedrock layout. At 100.100 you'll find this one. In 1.18 the world will be deeper. So the bedrock layer will be at minus 64. Because of this, in all pre-existing chunks, bedrock will fill everything between Y0 and Y-64. That way you won't accidentally fall into the void when mining. If you're in a village during the night, you might witness groups of zombies spawning near the edge of the village. The amount depends entirely on how many villagers there are. Sieges can happen anywhere except for the mushroom biome. Zombies spawned in the siege are always normal zombies, never zombie villagers, husks or drowned. But sieges are an exclusive Java Edition feature, another reason why Java is superior. August 20th, 2009, Notch decided to add pigs into Minecraft, but he messed up and this is what showed up on the screen. He said, "It looks creepier when animated, I'll keep it for a creepy creature." And the following month, Minecraft welcomed a brand new mob, creepers. One secret thing Notch added is that if a creeper explodes while having a potion effect, it'll leave behind an area effect cloud of that very effect. Next time you're in spectator mode, try clicking on a mob. You'll get their vision and see everything the mob sees. This works on all kinds of entities, not just mobs. Some mobs have special vision effects. Creepers have pixelated and green tinted vision. Endermen see inverted colors. And spiders have quintuple vision, slight blurring and high FOV. Pressing F4 removes the effect and your vision will return back to normal. If you were to play Minecraft in beta 1.9, you might come across two glass pillars spanning into the sky. This structure was super rare, therefore not many players found it. So why were there two seemingly random pillars in Minecraft? Well, they used to mark the location of the stronghold, because the eyes of Ender were not yet added. The few players that did find these pillars thought that it was Herobrine's doing, because at the time, the story of Herobrine was believed to be true. Prior to Minecraft beta, the Farlands was an area generated at the end of every Minecraft world. But the world didn't end there. If you kept walking, you'd eventually reach Farther Lands, a variation of the Farlands, which was smoother and more stretched out. This area generated about 80 times farther from spawn than the Farlands did, around the vicinity of 1 billion blocks. That's a long walk. One day, the YouTuber Kilo Crazy Man became the first person in the history of Minecraft to reach Farlands by foot. Notch himself was so impressed that he made a $10,000 donation. If you knew any of this, good job, but don't celebrate, because you have absolutely no chance on the next ones. Back in Indev, bows used to be more like machine guns. It was around this time that little Dadusak first experienced this wonderful game. If you pressed right click while holding a bow, you'd start shooting arrows like crazy. Actually, at first, you didn't even need a bow to shoot arrows. You could just press tab to shoot them. When the bow was added, the texture looked like this, but Notch changed it to the one we have today. Unfortunately, in pre-release beta, the charging mechanic was added, and that was the end of machine gun bows. Number 15. Splashing an Enderman with a potion of invisibility will make it invisible. However, you can still see the Enderman's eyes for some reason. This doesn't happen with any other mob. Notch claimed that the Enderman is a, quote, subtle reference to the Slenderman. With their inverted vision, Endermen see cobblestone as endstone, because endstone is literally a yellowish version of cobblestone. The texture of the oak sapling has been changed 5 times in the history of its existence. In Infdev, saplings used to grow into fancy trees, but then Notch changed it back to regular trees. There are actually 15 different variations of saplings. However, most of them have this texture and are inaccessible through normal gameplay. Saplings also require a light level of at least 9 to grow. Personally, I didn't know that. Number 19. Creepers are perhaps the deadliest mob in Minecraft, because they don't make any special sounds. So putting blast protection on your armor is a choice a lot of players tend to make. But there's another way to deal with creepers, and that is wearing a creeper hat. Detection range of creepers is reduced by 50% when you're wearing their hat. On October 11th, 2010, Notch tweeted, "I'm working on the most unfair mob ever. You will hate the ghast." Originally, ghasts used to spawn near nether portals in the overworld. Fortunately, this idea was quickly scratched. Now they can only spawn in basalt deltas, nether wastes, and soul sand valley. In Minecraft Alpha, the ability to shoot fireballs was added. However, they looked like snowballs that are set on fire. Currently, there are 167 different ambient sounds in Minecraft. Those are the sounds that play semi-randomly in the background. They are divided into 3 groups: cave, underwater, and nether. If you press F3, you can see the mood. It increases when you're in a cave or a dark place. When it reaches 100, Minecraft makes one of these sounds. That's the random scary noise you hear when mining. Number 22. The Frostwalker enchantment protects you from campfires and magma blocks, which is kinda ironic. In addition, the ice created from Frostwalker lasts longer during the night because there is no sunlight to melt it. Also, enchanted boots with Frostwalker can be applied on foxes. However, this only works on Bedrock Edition. When first added, Frostwalker used to work on flowing water too. Diamonds were initially called emeralds, until Notch wanted to add the actual emeralds into the game, so he had to change the name. In Indev, diamonds could be obtained by smelting diamond blocks in a furnace. A stack of 100 diamonds could be found in the Indev house chest. Dadusak, what's an Indev house? It was a structure which acted as the starting place when you first spawned in a new world. The Indev house was made of mossy cobblestone with 2 torches and 3 chests containing all items in stacks of 99. Later, the house design was changed to be made out of planks and stone, and the item stacks went from 99 to 100. That's a noticeable change. However, in early Infdev, the Indev house was removed. Number 25. If you try to sleep in the nether, you're gonna have a bad time. But for some reason, if you put a villager into the nether, wait for the night to begin, and place a bed beside him, the villager will lie down like there's no tomorrow, and the bed will not explode. At least they don't have to sleep sideways. Yeah, that's what I did in my sideways world. That video is a must watch.